Okay, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So, the topic of discussion today is the sources of vital statistics. I'm Dr. Inaalmul Haq, Assistant Professor in the Department of Community Medicine, Government Medical College, Srinagar. So, if you can see this picture, this is a picture of a person marking a house, giving the house some ID, and this picture has been taken from the 2011 census. Here you can see some workers recording some information in the 2011 census. This is the proposed format for the Census of India 2021. And the households will be asked about 31 questions in this census. We shall be discussing about the various sources of vital statistics. And we'll focus on three main sources: the civil registration system, the census, and the sample registration system. We'll briefly discuss the National Family Health Surveys and the National Sample Survey. Now, first, let's enumerate the different sources of vital statistics. I do hope that by now, you know what vital statistics is. Usually, I would say it involves the births and deaths, so that we can calculate the birth rate and death rate and maybe some other rates as well. Now, any rate will have a numerator and a denominator. So in order to calculate a rate like a birth rate or a death rate, we need the information about the numerator and we need the information about the denominator. For example, in a birth rate, the numerator is the number of live births in a particular population during a definite period, usually 1 year. And the denominator is the mid-year population during that particular period. Now, the primary source for the numerator, that's the number of births or the number of deaths, is the civil registration system. And the primary source for the denominator, that's the mid-year population, comes from census. Because we don't just need the birth rates, we need the birth rates for different subgroups as well. For example, for SCs or STs or some occupational groups or some particular members of the society. Then there is one more important source for the numerator, which is the sample registration system. And then we have some others like the National Family Health Survey, the National Sample Survey, or maybe hospital statistics or surveys. Now, if we think, where do we get this information about vital statistics from? The first thing that might click is that usually most of the births are institutional. They take place in hospitals. Most of the people, when they fall sick, they are taken to the hospital and they usually die in hospitals. So hospital statistics is a good data. It's a good source wherein we can obtain data about vital statistics. Now, what happens to the births that take place in hospitals? A birth takes place in the hospital. It gets recorded in the hospital. But then you see, nowadays, in order to get admission of a child in the school, you need a birth certificate. Usually, in most of the schools, you won't get an admission unless you have a birth certificate. So this record from the hospital, now we have a more efficient system of recording of births and deaths under the civil registration system. So this birth that takes place in the hospital, this gets this record gets transferred to the municipality of that particular area under the civil registration system. So first let's discuss about the civil registration system, and as I said, this is the primary source for vital statistics because it gives us information about the numerator, the number of deaths, the number of births in a particular area. Now what is a civil registration system? A civil registration system is a continuous, permanent, compulsory and universal recording of the occurrence and characteristics of vital events in accordance with the legal requirements in a country. So it's compulsory, it's universal, and it's a continuous process. As births happen, they are recorded, deaths happen, they are recorded. And as I said, this is the most common source of vital statistics. Previously, it was voluntary, that's the registration of a birth or death was voluntary, but with the enactment of the Registration of Births and Deaths Act 1969, it was made mandatory. Now, every birth and death is to be registered with what is known as the chief registrar within 21 days. Now, there's a term that we use, which is level of registration. That is the percentage of total events that have been registered. So what percentage of total births or total deaths occurring in a particular area have been registered? It was found that in 2012, this level of registration was only 69% for deaths and 84% for births. And it has been increasing. And now that we have a more efficient system of registration of births and deaths, the figures have risen. Now, if you want more information about the civil registration system in India or about the Registration of Births and Deaths Act 1969, I have given you links over here so you can visit those websites and find out more about the civil registration system or the Registration of Births and Deaths Act 1969. Now, the primary source for denominator in calculation of vital statistics is the census. Census, as you might know, is an official, periodical, complete enumeration of the population. So, two key terms over here are it's periodical and it's a complete enumeration of the population. So, everybody in the population, every person in the population, every household in the entire population gets enumerated. The word basically comes from the Latin censere, which was used in the Roman Republic, wherein they would keep a track of all adult males who are fit for military service. So they want to know that in case there is a war, how many persons do we have to fight? Now, usually the periodicity of census in India is 10 years. So the census is carried out every 10 years. So we had a census in 2001, we had a census in 2011, then we are going to have a census in 2021. That's why it's sometimes known as the decennial census or the decadal census. Now, the responsibility for conducting the census rests with the Office of the Registrar General and Census Commissioner, India, under the Ministry of Home Affairs, Government of India. So, the census, it generates data on population statistics, including vital statistics. Okay? If you need more information on the census, you can visit the Census India website, which is censusindia.gov.in. If you want to know the total population of your area, you want to know the total number of households in your area, or in your village, in your town, in your district, and how many households are there, and various other information like what type of households are there, how many persons live, what's their social status, etc., etc., then you can basically visit this website and find out more. The next, as I said, is the sample registration system. This is another important source for the numerator in case of vital statistics. Now, It was found that because the level of registration under the RPD Act and the civil registration system was not satisfactory, we need some way to make more reliable estimates of the number of births and deaths in the country. Therefore, the Office of the Registrar General came up with the idea of having a sample registration system, wherein the registration of births and deaths in India is recorded on a representative sample of the population. Okay, so herein, this is different from the civil registration system because in here, not all births and deaths are registered. It's only in some selected areas which are statistically selected. These are areas which are representative of the entire population. So in these areas only, the births and deaths are recorded. This was first started on a pilot basis and then went on a full scale from 1969-70. So since 1969-70, we have data from the sample registration system on a regular basis. If you go to the sample registration system website on the Census of India website, I have given the link. I'll share the link. Therein you will find that they have what we call as the SRS bulletins, which are basically published every 6 monthly. So you will have the latest SRS bulletin will be available on the website. Now, the sample registration system is a dual record system, which means that it records the number of births and number of deaths, maybe some other information as well, from two different sources. One is a continuous enumeration of births and deaths by a part-time enumerator. That's known, he or she is known as an enumerator. So he or she records the births and deaths in that the chosen sample or the chosen village or the urban block on a continuous basis. Then there is one other person, the supervisor, who records these births and deaths retrospectively every 6 monthly. Okay. The supervisor is a full-time employee, records the births and deaths retrospectively every 6 months, right? Then the data from these two, the enumerator and the supervisor, they are matched. And in case there is partial matching or the data do not match, then the actual events will be re-verified in the field. The main objective of the sample registration system, as I said, was to provide reliable estimates of birth rate, death rate, and infant mortality rate, right? But it also provides data for other measures of fertility and mortality, including the total fertility, infant and child mortality rate. Now, one more thing that has been added to the sample registration system is that apart from just recording the deaths by the supervisor, the supervisors have been trained to perform what we call as a verbal autopsy in order to know the cause of those deaths. So every death that happens in that particular area, in that particular sample, the supervisor not just records those deaths, but then he asks the household member some questions about what basically caused the death. This is something we know as a verbal autopsy. So this is done by the supervisors. So that way we know the cause of the death. So this is a verbal autopsy, V-E-R-B-A-L, verbal autopsy. Now, as I said that if you want to know the latest SRS data, then you can visit this website, which gives you the SRS bulletins. And if you want to know more about the sample registration system, I have given you the link to the sample registration system website as well. Now, these were the three primary sources, the civil registration system, the census, and the sample registration system. Then there are a few others as well. For example, the National Family Health Survey. The National Family Health Survey is a large-scale, multi-round survey conducted in a representative sample of households throughout India. Again, this is a survey which is conducted in a representative sample of households. So it usually provides information about the maternal and child health indicators at the state level as well as the national level. Okay? So many maternal and child health indicators, for example, fertility, infant and child mortality, practice of family planning, reproductive health, nutrition, anemia, and the utilization and quality of health and family planning services. So the National Family Health Surveys, they the responsibility for the conduct, coordination, and the guidance for those surveys has been given to the International Institute of Population Sciences, Mumbai, IIPS Mumbai. So this is the organization that basically carries out those surveys, National Family Health Surveys. Now it has two specific goals. One is to provide essential data on health and family welfare, which is needed by many other agencies as well for policy and program purposes. And then it also gives some information on important emerging health and family welfare issues. Four family health surveys, the National Family Health Surveys, have been conducted till now, and their data is available on the website, which is, I have given the link to the website, rthiips.org/nfhs. So you can find those fact sheets. Basically, fact sheets are basically a summary of the findings of the National Family Health Surveys. So you can find the fact sheets are available for the state level as well as the national level. Four have been conducted till now. The fifth round has been conducted, but we don't have the data as yet. Maybe in the coming few months, we might have the data for the NFHS-5 also available at the website. The first one was conducted in 1992-93, and the latest one was conducted in 2018-19. The last one is the National Sample Survey. Now, the National Sample Survey under the Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation basically conducts surveys on socioeconomic indicators. And it's a nationwide household survey. Many surveys have been conducted, and in some of those surveys, they record some health information as well. The first full-scale NSS health survey was conducted in 1973-74. And the latest health survey by the National Statistical Office is the 75th round that was conducted in 2017-18. So you can see the enormity of this survey, that in the 75th round, they have selected households over rural and urban areas of every district in the country. So they covered every district in the country. And then they randomly selected 113,823 households. Then this information from 113,823 households is then extrapolated to the entire population. So if you want to know more about the National Sample Survey, you can visit this website. I have given you the link over here. So you can find out more about National Sample Survey if you are interested. So the last one would be, as I said, the hospital records and surveys. For example, you go to a particular field practice area, say somewhere in Block Hazratbal, and you conduct a survey over there and ask them about how many deaths or how many births have taken place in your household in the last maybe 3 months or 6 months or 1 year. And then this also can be a source to know about the sample survey. To know about vital statistics, or maybe sometimes a researcher may be interested in finding out the infant mortality rate of a particular area, or the birth rate or the death rate in a particular area. That also may serve as a source for vital statistics, but these are very minor sources. So that's it. Thank you very much.